Hello children, welcome to our EVS2 lecture. In our last EVS2 lecture, that is lesson number 6, we have studied about the revision. Okay, now lesson number 6 is getting to know the place we live in. In that, how old man became a man. Okay, that is how from monkey, that is from ape, became the man. How the man started living a proper life. How man learned the agriculture, that is farming. Then how different places got different names. These things we have studied in the last lesson, that is lesson number 6. Getting to know the place we live in. Even the lesson revision is also over. Now we are going to study a new lesson. Lesson number 7. Okay. We are going to study new lesson, lesson number 7, our village, our city. So children, this is lesson number 7, our village, our city. In this picture, what you can see children? You can see many houses, then market is there, bullock carts, people are buying and some people are selling. Then you can see small houses, then you can see bus, ST bus, then temple, and then side of it the river. So this picture, what you can come to know, city or village? It is a village. Children, it is what? A village. In village, people are doing farming. Then, they are using bullock carts. Okay. Water you can see here. Then, well is there where water is available. Okay. So, this is what? Village. Now, next picture. What you can see in this picture? You can see buildings. You can see what? Buildings. Then cars. Children playing in the park. Scooter. People are walking on the road. Then your traffic jam is there. Okay. Then your small houses are there. That is a slum. Okay. Then factories also is there. Your. Okay. And there are many buildings. Everywhere there are what? Buildings. So, in village, the houses are very small. There are more number of trees, plants. Okay, everywhere greenery is there. But in city, you will find very less greenery. And everywhere you will find buildings. Okay. But, children, tell me one thing. City is more developed or village is more developed. Okay. In village, the facilities which are available in city are not available in village. For example, big hospital. So big hospital is not available in village. It is available in city. Okay. Then in village, small medical care center is there. That is health center. You can see over here. Okay. And in city, you will find it big hospital. And then in city, there are shopping malls. Okay. In village, there are only small shops or a market. Okay, children? So, now let's move to this page number 40. These were the page number 39 and 38. Okay? So, in village, there are bullock carts, ST bus. Okay, there are no roads. Then, in a city, there are roads, proper roads are there, okay. Proper garden is there. In village, there is no garden, okay. Then there are no proper road, there is no proper water facility, there is no tap. In city, there is water facility, that is taps and all. Okay. So, the facilities are different, which are available in village and which are available in the city. Okay, now let's move on to page number 40. Can you tell. Now, six pictures are shown here. Umbrella is shown, then cabbage is shown, apple, cauliflower, jacket, bicycle. So children, you have to tell me these things are made in factory or which things are available on a farm. Okay, now we are doing online teaching, this is recorded videos. Okay, you cannot reply, that is you cannot talk, or what you say I can't hear, but just keep in mind what I am telling. First one, which of the things in these pictures are produced on a farm? So farm, which things are produced? Umbrella? No. Cabbage? Yes. Apple? Yes. Cauliflower? Yes. Second question, where else can these things be obtained? So other, where else you can, these things are obtained? Okay, where else you get? In the market. Where you get? In the market. Third one, which articles in the picture are produced in a factory? Now, which articles are produced in a factory? Umbrella, okay, yes. Cauliflower, no. Apple, no. Cabbage, no. Jacket, yes, produced in a factory. Bicycle, yes, produced in a factory. Then question number 4, where else can you find these articles? In the shops. Where you find these articles? Umbrella, bicycle, jackets, where it is available? From where people buy? From the shop, from the market, from the malls. Okay, so how they come there in the malls? First, it is manufactured in the factory, it is made in the factory, and from there it is transported to the shops and malls. Fifth number, for what purpose do we need these things? Now, for what purpose we use these things, above mentioned things? The umbrella. When you use umbrella during the rainy season. Then second is cabbage. So when you use cabbage, you use anywhere? No, it is used for eating purpose. Then apple, we eat apple. Cabbage, we eat apple. Next, jacket. A jacket we wear when it is cold. Bicycle, we ride bicycle. Okay, for riding purpose, for driving purpose. Last one, which means of transport are used to move these goods to urban and rural areas? Now, urban and rural areas, children, see these two pictures again. I'm showing you all. This picture means village, and this picture means city. So, urban means city, and rural means village. Okay, again, I'm repeating, urban means city, and rural means village. Now, on this picture, there are some points given. Study the picture carefully. Learn about the difference between city and a village and based on the following points. Houses, dress, means of transport, industry, facilities. Apart from this, list the things you have seen in the city and the village. Okay, so see the houses over here in village, that is rural, and see the houses in the city, that is the urban. So urban, there are houses, there are buildings, and in rural, that is village, there are small houses. Then dress code is also different. People's dress code in village is different, that is rural, and these people staying in urban, the dress code is also different. So urban means village, urban means city, urban means city, and rural means village. So, means of transport. So, means of transport means for traveling purpose from one place to another. In rural, that is in village, what is used? Bullock cart. Okay. ST bus is used. Okay. Then some people are traveling by walking. Then bicycle is used. Okay. In city, that is urban, what is used? Cars are used, auto rickshaw, bike, scooter. These things are used, okay, in urban. This is the means of transport of urban people. Then industry, in village there are very small scale industry. In city, that is urban, there are big industries. Okay, then facilities, Now here, people have to remove water from the well in the village. In the city, the water is directly available in their houses through pipes. Okay, so there are different facilities available in village and city. So, which means of transport are used to move these goods to urban and rural areas? Now, means of transport, there are different types of transport: airways, waterways and roadways. So there are three types of transport: airways, waterways and roadways. So these are three types of transport. Now I'm showing the picture, three types of transport. This is airway, aeroplane. This is waterway, ship. And this is roadway, beta. This is roadway. Okay, bullock carts. Then it can be truck, SUVs. Okay. Now this is the village. Okay, village. The houses are very small. Okay, and in city the houses are very big. Grains, vegetables, milk, etc. come from village. Now vegetables. Now what is vegetable, children? These are called vegetable. There are different types of vegetable: cucumber, yellow onion, red onion, garlic, carrot, red cabbage, white cabbage, radish, eggplant, mushroom, red pepper, then artichoke, corn, beet, broccoli, cauliflower, celery, red chili, green chili, sweet potato, asparagus, olives, pumpkin, fennel, spring onion, then turnip, green beans, avocado, lettuce and zucchini. Okay, these are what? Vegetables. So these vegetables from where you get? From the village. Who cultivates, produces this? Farmer. Okay, farmer does lot of hard work. They cultivate on their land, on their farm. Then these vegetables require lot of hard work. They have to give water, they have to provide medicine for them. Okay, milk. Who gives milk? Cows and buffalo. Cows give the milk. Okay, and that's from there it is transported to city through different ways, through trucks. Okay, through trucks it is transported to city. Then grains. Now grains like moong, masoor, tur dal, moong dal, this is also cultivated by farmers on their farm, etc. come from villages. Bicycle, toys, books, etc. come from the city. So from where bicycle, toys, books, etc. come? They comes from where? From the city. Now this is the picture of toys. You are familiar with these toys, okay children? You must be also having different types of toys. So these toys are made where? In the factory. These are made in the factory. This is factory. There are different types of factory: toys factory, books factory, bicycle factory, clothes factory. Okay, so there are different types of factory. Some are big factories, some are small factories. So toys are produced in the factory, then these books are also made in the factories. Okay, bicycles are also manufactured in the factory. So, and they come from the city. Now see this, children, this bicycle, toys, books, etc., it is not manufactured in the village. Okay, it is not made in this village, it is made in the city. So from city it is transported to village through truck. Okay, through what? Through truck. So that means village people are dependent on city and city people are dependent on village people. Okay, why they are dependent on each other, children? To fulfill their needs. Now what are their needs? Bicycle, toys, books, etc. is not made in the village. So these also the village people require. And vegetable, milk, grain, it is not cultivated in the city. So these also things the village city people require. So they are depended on each other. Farming implements, cloth, medicines, automobiles, soap, glass, light bulbs, etc. are made in factories. Now farming implements. Now there are different types of farming implements. Plow is used for initial cultivation of soil for sowing seeds. Then pick and scythe. Pick is used for what? Used for breaking up hard ground or rock. Pick is used for breaking up hard ground or rock. Okay. Then this is digging stick. This is axe. It's used for cutting the wood. This is also hoe. It's an agriculture tool used to remove small amounts of soil. And sickle used for cutting the grass, cutting the harvesting crops. Okay, children. So these things are manufactured in the factory. Now clothes. We wear clothes. These clothes are also made in the factory. Medicines, we take medicines when we are not well. Your parents, grandparents, they also take medicines when they are not well. So where it is made? It is made in the factory. Automobiles. Now what is automobile, children? Automobile means car. Car, aeroplane, these things are made in the factories. Soaps. Now what is soap? When we bath with what? Soap. We use soap. Then glass, light bulbs. Light bulbs are used for giving us light. It is electrical light, etc. are made in factories. So factories are mostly situated near the city. So in city only there are factories. So only factory? No, people are also staying in the city. So, but most of the factories are where? In the city compared to the village. In village only small factories are there. And in city there are big factories, that is in urban, and this is rural. Factories are mostly situated near the city. People living both in villages and cities use all these things. So people living both in village and city. So people living in village and city, they use soap, they use light bulb, they use glass. Okay, they use medicine, they use cloth, they use farming implements. So both use the things. Both people, that is people living in urban and people living in rural. Thus, rural and urban people are dependent on each other for their needs. So whatever their needs are there, they are dependent on each other. How are you dependent on your parents? You are not earning now. You are taking your studying. You are taking your studies. You are taking education. So that means you all are dependent on your parents. So same way, this rural and urban people are dependent on each other. Now, these things are grown in the village, which are manufactured in village, they are sent to the city, that is to the urban. And these things are made in urban, they are sent to the rural. So both the people are using this, both the people require this. So that means they are dependent on each other. Rural people are dependent on urban people, that means city people are dependent on village people. Okay. Now for what things they are dependent on each other? In urban, factories are there. So the things which are made in factories are available in urban. The things which are made on cultivated by farmers, cultivated on the farm, this farm, that is available in the village, that is rural. Okay, so this things required by urban people also for eating purpose, that is vegetables, fruits, grains, milk. Okay, so this is transported to urban, and the things made in factories, that is cycle, bicycle, that is books, toys, etc., then soap, farming implements, that is transported to rural, that is village. Thus, rural and urban people are dependent on each other for their needs. Means of transport and communication are necessary to fulfill their needs, the needs of the people. So, what is required? Means of transport and communication. Now, communication is done means what? Communication means sending and receiving messages. Communication means sending and receiving messages. That is called communication. And means of transport. Transport means going from one place to another. That is called transport. So, ancient time, people were not having bikes. So, people were using bullock cart. What they were using? Bullock cart. Okay. Then, slowly, people started developing. Then, they started using bicycle. Then, the bike and then car. Okay, so means of transport, that is the vehicle which is used to go from one place to another, is called means of transport. So there are three types of means of transport nowadays, that is airways, waterways and roadways. So what is coming in airway? That is aeroplane. Aeroplane is coming in airway. This ship is coming in waterway. Then roadway, train is coming in roadway, as this bus is coming in roadway, truck is coming in roadway. Okay, so this is roadway. Next folks, earlier there was a big difference between the city and the village. Now this difference is reducing. The facilities available in cities are now available, becoming available in villages as well. So earlier there was big difference. There was every facility available in the city, but in village it was not available. But nowadays, as everything is developing, advanced technology is there. So the things which are available in city are also becoming available in the village. So because of development and because of increasing education, people are changing their lifestyle. So that's why the things which are available in city are also available in village. Means of transport. As man needs increased, he invented new means of transport. Earlier, goods were transported by animals like bullocks, elephants, camels, horses and donkeys. So first, goods were transported where? On donkey, then elephant, then horses. This is horse, this is donkey, this is elephant. Okay children? So they were transported on donkey, horse, elephant, then bullock cart. They were using bullock cart for transporting. But nowadays it is not that way. So earlier man was using these animals for transporting from one place to another. That is goods. Goods means what? Goods means what? The produce thing. That is, it can be vegetables, fruits, or it can be anything. It needs to be transported to. Which needs to be taken from one place to another. Next, vehicles such as bullock carts and horse carts were used. Then, sheep, automobiles and trains were invented, followed by aeroplane. So, slowly, man started using bullock cart and horse cart. Then man invented automobiles. That what is automobile? Cars, different types of cars. Then invented trains. So ancient time this way trains were used first. Okay. And then man invented slowly aeroplanes. So thus transport becomes faster. So by aeroplane you can travel to different place in a very short time. Okay. So by aeroplane you can travel to America, you can travel to Canada, you can travel to Australia. Okay. So by aeroplane you can go to different states within very short time. So that's why traveling became easier because of means of transport. Understood children? Up here, next page. What you can see here children? This is the picture shown means of transport and the ways, that is roadway, waterway and ship, that is shown. So train is also a roadway transport. Bullock cart is roadway, but which road you can see over here? Two roads are there. So bullock cart travels from village road where more number of trees and plants are there. You can see the second column, second one. Okay. Ship is which way? Water, that is last one. Train on the tracks, that is roadway. Bus is on the roadway. Then aeroplane, sky, third one. And truck is also roadway. Nowadays transport facilities are available in most villages and cities. Study the map. So this map, nowadays these facilities are available in both the places, that is village and city, that is urban and rural. But ancient time people were not having these facilities in villages. Okay, so children, we have finished up to here, up to the means of transport. Now we'll study about the means of transport according to the map in our next lesson. Okay, if you have any doubt, post it on the students portal. Post it on students portal. I will try to solve it. Till then, take care of yourself, of your family. Okay. Have a nice day. Okay. Thank you.